The Kraft Foods Company brings you The Adventures of the Falcon, starring Les Damon.
Hello? Yes, this is the Falcon speaking.
Oh, Denise.
Thanks for calling, but I can't make it tonight, Angel. $250,000 worth of jewelry is missing. And when that much ice is on the loose, someone is likely to get frozen stiff.
This is Ed Herlihy, friends, inviting you on behalf of the Kraft Foods Company to listen to The Adventures of the Falcon. You met the Falcon first in his best-selling novels. Then you saw him in his thrilling motion picture series. Now join him on the air when the Falcon solves the case of the double nephews. Before we join the Falcon in his latest adventure, I'd like to tell you folks about Kraft's golden cheese food, Velveeta. Velveeta is such good eating. Just taste that grand, rich, yet mild cheddar cheese flavor. And Velveeta is so good for you. It's rich in important food values from milk itself. For swell-tasting snacks, for good hearty sandwiches, for thrifty, easy hot dishes, it's smart to keep stocked with Velveeta. Get it tomorrow in the handy quarter-pound package or in the economical 2-pound loaf. The cheese food of top quality. Velveeta is made only by Kraft. And now, the case of the double nephews. It's early Sunday morning in New York when Tom Lacey enters his apartment. He clicks on the light, looks around nervously, then walks quickly to the door to the bedroom. Goes in, turns on the bedside lamp between the twin beds, tosses a briefcase on his own bed, then turns to the other bed and shakes the shoulder of his pretty wife.
Julie, wake up.
What is
it? I've got to talk to you.
In the morning.
Do you love me, Julie?
Huh?
Do you love me?
Well, what kind of a
question? Do you?
Ow, my shoulder.
I've got to know.
You've been drinking.
Now, look, I'm serious.
What time is it, anyway? Oh, no. 3 o'clock. Go to bed, will you?
Now, Julie, listen to me. Julie, I've done something. It's hard to explain.
Another woman?
No, nothing like that. Well, it's going to mean... Well, I'm going to have to go away. I want you to go with me. I want you to stick by me. Will you?
What have you done?
Will you stick by me, no matter what?
What have you done?
I robbed the vault when I closed up last night.
Robbed?
Yeah. More than $250,000 worth of jewelry.
Tom.
I know it was a crazy thing to do, but I blew my top. For 4 years, I've almost been running the firm. You know that. Yesterday, I find out Carraway's retiring. You know I've been counting on them making me manager when he quit.
And they didn't.
A wire came from the Forrest family estate in Oregon. Old man Forrest is sending one of his nephews, Ev Forrest, a kid right out of school, never been in New York, doesn't know a thing about the business. He's going to take over.
Wouldn't you know?
Well, do you blame me, Junie? Do you blame me for getting sore? That's why I looted the safe. I was sore.
What's the good? They'll know you did it.
Well, I didn't stop to think. I just said to myself, they don't want me here, okay? I'll get out. Only I'm taking my share with me. I'm entitled to it.
What now?
Well, now? Well, I don't know. South America is something. You can go a long ways on what I took, Junie.
Where's the jewelry?
Right here in my briefcase.
Let's see it.
Why?
Just want to see what $250,000 looks like.
Oh, okay. There you are.
Tom, they're beautiful. How are you going to sell them?
Oh, there's always a market. We'll find someone in South America who won't get what they're worth, but we ought to clear somewhere around $100,000.
$100,000? You shouldn't have done it, Tom.
Well, it's too late to think of that now. I can't put it back. There's a time lock on the vault.
You're a thief.
Well, what do you want me to do?
You know, I think I'm going to like South America.
Are you sure there's nothing? No. No. That'll be too late. I see. All right, never mind. Goodbye.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.